Hi, my name is Emily Lauk, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the Common Sense Media lesson that I chose. As you can see on my screen, the lesson that I chose is called Pause for People, and it is set up for children in kindergarten. I'm actually currently a preschool teacher, so I just chose the grade level that was closest to that. I chose this lesson because I feel like as we are starting to introduce technology to young children, it's also important that we are going alongside that and teaching them how to use it responsibly and respectably. In early childhood classroom, we're le teaching a lot of social skills, and just as we are teaching children how to do transitions and be finished with activities, it's also important that we're doing the same with technology, teaching them how to react when it's time to be done and how to pause our technology use for face-to-face interaction. So as we get into our lesson, it's laid out really well on this Common Sense Media site. And what I would start with first is just introducing the lesson. So we would talk about how people would feel when they're done playing with or using their technology, similarly to, like I said, how they feel when they have to be done playing toys or other things like that. So we'd probably talk about their feelings, frustration, sadness, things like that that they have to be done, either playing their game or working on the computer, things like that. I would then pull up the slides that they provided for us here on the website, and we would watch the pause, breathe, and finish up video, saying goodbye to technology. We would watch that video together, and then we would review what the video was about. I would have all the class do the pause, breathe, finish up chant, probably multiple times. And we'd also just talk about what each of those words mean or what those phrases mean, and have them practice that. I feel like they are pretty familiar with the chant. We would act out some of the scenarios that are provided in the lesson plan, and I would either call up a pair of kids or I could match them up. And they do it individually or in front of the whole class. And just one would be the adult, and the other would be the digital citizen, the student that's needing to say goodbye to the technology that they're using. As they're acting out these scenarios, we would talk about using each of these, the pause, breathe, and finish up, and what that would look like for different scenarios. Whether it is that they're actually having to be finished with a technology and put it away, or if a teacher or a parent is just trying to talk to them and they just need to pause and look up to pay attention to the person that's talking to them. After I feel like they're pretty familiar with that, then I would give them the worksheet that was provided, the pause and think moment. And on this worksheet, they would draw themselves doing the pause, breathe, and finish up routine. So we could talk about whether that would be at school or at home, whatever the situation may be, they can choose that. And then on the bottom, they would write a word or a sentence to explain what's going on in their picture. So, like I said, as if they're doing this at home, on maybe their iPad or a TV, or if they're at school, also on an iPad or maybe during computer class on the computer. So they would have a chance to draw their own picture here. Depending on the time frame of how our lesson is going, they may have the opportunity to share this screen, this picture with kids, the rest of the kids in the class. When they're done with this, then I would bring out this poster, the pause, breathe, and finish up poster that is also provided on the website. And this would be hung up in the classroom, probably in multiple places, maybe by the iPad station or by where the computers are at, just so that we can be using the same verbiage throughout the rest of the year, so that the kids are familiar with that and can practice it throughout the rest of the year as they're using technology. The educator standard that I feel like this lesson matches with is the Citizen, the 3A, which is create experiences for learners to make positive, socially ex responsible contributions and exhibit empathetic behavior online that builds relationships and community. I feel like this is just, like I said, the social skills of how to properly and respectfully use technology. And the student standard that I feel like this lesson follows is Digital Citizen 2B, which is students engage in positive, safe, legal, and ethical behavior when using technology, including social interactions online and when using networked devices. So, like I said, this is again social skills. So it is just teaching them that we can be using technology, but we also are needing to be respectful when we're having the face-to-face interactions or being respectful when technology time is completed. Thank you.